Hello there, my name is Mac Horse, and welcome to the 5th episode of Blockbuster Tutorial Series. In this video, I'll show you how to edit player recordings. As with previous episode, you'll need Aperture Mod for this video as well. So, the simplest way to start editing a player recording is to open Scenes panel, select a replay, and click on the Edit Record button. That will take you to the Player Recording Editor panel, in which you can add blocks on the bottom timeline. Here I have a little demonstration of all of these blocks. Every block here is an action. Every one of these has a unique function. You can use the Player Recording Editor either to clean up actions, as in some cases Player Recorder can malfunction, and it requires manual cleaning up to resolve minor issues, or to add special effects, which make the scene look very cool. Now let's talk about the GUI controls of this panel. In the top right corner, you can see three horizontal lines icon, which opens recording sidebar, in which you can pick the player recording you're currently editing. On the bottom, you have an action editor. The numbers on the bottom are indicator at which tick these actions are placed. You can scroll mouse wheel, or horizontally drag, in order to move horizontally in the timeline. Alternatively, you can drag the scroll bar. You can drag vertically, or scroll mouse wheel while holding shift, to navigate vertically in the timeline. And finally, you can scroll the mouse wheel while holding alt, to zoom in and out horizontally. Buttons on the right allow to add an action from the list, duplicate an action, and remove an action. Those are pretty straightforward. You can also move action blocks in the timeline, by dragging and dropping them. And finally, buttons on the left allow you to cut, copy and paste actions. Those are self-explanatory as well. Now let's get to actual overview of all of these actions. But before we do that, let me show you one more thing that will make action editing much easier. Beside editing player recordings from this panel, you can also edit actions in the camera editor, when syncing actors. Go to Scenes panel, and click Edit the Camera button. This will open the camera editor with actors being synchronized. Now, the two icon buttons from the left and the right of the timeline allow you to toggle player recording timeline and recordings sidebar. It works the same way as in the player recording editor panel, for exception that you can see changes made to the player recordings right after you edited an action. Let's start with actions in chronological order. Chat action makes an actor output a message into the chat. You can use left square bracket as a code formatter. Check the description for a link to Minecraft's wiki page about color code formatting. Swipe action allows you to add swiping animation to the character. Item drop action allows you to make an actor drop an item where it looks, regardless whether an actor has this item stack in its inventory or not. You can specify any item stack using this item picker. Equip item action allows you to change armor and hand equipment slots. In the center of the screen, you can pick an item you want to be equipped, and on the bottom left, you can pick to which slot the picked item will be equipped. If you want to unequip an item, simply press on any of the empty slots in your inventory, and it will act as an unequip action. Shoot an arrow action allows you to shoot an arrow, regardless whether an actor holds a bow or not. The field at the bottom specifies the power of the arrow. The bigger the number, the more damage it will deal and the further it will shoot. Sadly, it doesn't support custom enchanted arrows. Place block action allows you to set a block at given coordinates. The top field is the ID of the block. The second field is the meta value of the block, and the last three are XYZ coordinates of where the block should be placed. Mounting action allows you to mount an actor to an entity that the actor is looking at. You shouldn't really use this action, because it's really glitchy. However, you most likely want to remove this action, if you have any scene where an actor sits on a modded chair. Otherwise, this happens. Interact block makes an actor to interact with a block, kind of like when you right-click on a block. Break block breaks a block at given XYZ position. You can also toggle whether the broken block should be dropped as an item stack. And now the most used action in the entire mod, meet the morph action. As you guessed, what it does is morphs an actor. This is how all the animations, poses, and other cool effects are done. You add a morph action, pick a morph, and then the actor will turn into picked morph. There is also a shortcut, which is Ctrl plus M, which allows you to add a morph action without the list. Play around with this one, like, a lot. Attack action allows you to cause damage to an entity at which an actor looks at. The soul field in the panel allows you to configure how many hit points will be dealt. 20 will be enough to kill a zombie, a skeleton, or a player. Damage action is like attack action, but instead the damage is inflicted upon the actor itself. Morph action. Action invokes morph's action. This action is rarely used, however, it works with specific morphs like creeper morph, blaze morph, etc. Command action allows you to execute a command as this actor. There are plenty of things you can do like particles, change the time, spawn entities, or whatever you can come up with. Break block animation action allows you to make blocks appear like they're damaged, similar to as when you break a block in survival mode. The top field is intensity, and the remaining are coordinates. Item use action allows you to make an actor interact with currently held item stack in a specific slot. It's probably best to use with an equip action. You can use this button to pick in which slot to use an item. I'm not going to go too much into item block use action, as it's really hard to manipulate it, as there is a lot of data must be filled in order to make it working. But what it does is similar to item use action. However, its result varies based on held item. Interact with entity action allows you to add an action that makes an actor interact with an entity at which it looks. Some examples are like item frame interaction. This action sadly requires fake player action to be enabled to work. And finally, there is also an emoticons action, if emoticons mod is installed. What it does is allows you to make an actor's emoticons morph to emote. In the soul field, you need to provide an emote ID, which you can find out from the tab completion of the emote command. That's basically it about actions. Hopefully, this video was useful, and now you know how to clean up and edit actions. This video concludes the new 2020 BB Academy series. Now you should be familiar with the basics of Blockbuster Mod. If you want to learn more about Blockbuster Mod, feel free to watch more videos about specific Blockbuster features on this channel. There should be plenty of content. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.